Have you decided where you're going to take your official visits?
I have a few in mind. North Carolina, I have a good relationship with their coaches there as well. I've talked with Coach John Blake, who's a minister as well. He's been in the ministry for quite some time. He came down whenever they were allowed to. We had a great talk. It wasn't all about football. It was just sitting out talking about the Lord and everything. And I really like that about him because he puts God first in everything he does. And he understands that if you're still talking about football, 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 you know, it gets overbearing because that's all everybody wants to talk about. And just the type of person he is and the way he conducted himself and carried himself and the demeanor that he had, it was just great all around as a person. I'm going to press toward the mark that the Lord has set for me because in the book of Philippians, the 3rd chapter, verse 13 and 14, it says, one thing I do, I forget those things which are behind. And I reach forward and I pursue as my goal the prize promised by God's heavenly call in Christ Jesus. Now see, that's another thing we do. We get caught up on the past. The past is the past, and until we find a way to come up with some time teleportation device, don't worry about the past because you can't do anything about it. I can't do anything about what's behind me. All I can do is press forward. And if you're not trying to get to where I'm going, don't bother me because I'm going on anyhow. Now I love my family. I love them from the bottom of my heart, but I just want to know, to let you know that if my daddy can't go, I'm gonna go on anyhow. If my mama can't go, I'm gonna go on anyhow. And even if my brother can't go, I'm gonna go on anyhow. And I want each and every one of you to know that if I can't go on, I want y'all to go on anyhow. Because I want you to go ahead and leave me behind because you need to go and get the prize that the Lord has for you. Go on and leave me behind. Go get yours because the Lord has it set for you. Now, whatever your prize may be, nobody else can deal with that prize. Whatever your prize may be, nobody else can touch that prize. Nobody can have that prize but you, and you cannot get that prize unless you get there. And you cannot get that prize if you're sitting here waiting on me. Like I said, things aren't always gonna go your way, and everyone isn't trying to get to where you're trying to go. And another thing I found out is that times are gonna get hard. There are gonna come times when the bills are gonna pile up on the table and it's gonna seem like you have no money in your pocket. There are gonna be times when you feel sickness in your body, feel like you just can't get well. But the Lord will make a way. There are going to come times when the family don't want to act right. The husband's not going to want to do right. The children are going to want to act up. But the Lord said, I'm a way out of no way. And along this life's journey here, there's going to come times when life is going to get scary. But you don't have to worry about being scared because the Bible told me that greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. And I'm glad today, too. I'm glad that I can look sickness in the face and say, move, I'm going on anyway. I can look at cancer and say, move, I'm going on anyway. I can look death straight in the eyes and say, yea, though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I will fear no evil because the Lord, he's with me. His rod and his staff, they comfort me. And it even went so far to say that even my enemies can't do anything to me. He's going to prepare a table for me in their presence. And how many people like to kick the feet up whenever they eat? Whenever he prepares that table for you, he's going to have everything you need for you. He said that he'll make your enemies your footstool. And that's another thing I found out here on life's journey, that if you go on anyhow, the world can't do you no harm. Now watch this. Satan has one purpose and one plan in his life. His plan is to steal, kill, and destroy. Now Satan is sitting back in the shadows right now, throwing rocks and trying to hide his hands. He's going to try to put stumbling blocks in your way. But we need to have an anyhow attitude. I don't know about you, but I'm going on anyhow. You can sit here if you want to and play church, but I'm going on anyhow. You can try to hold me back, but I'm going on anyhow. Let go of my tail, because I'm going on anyhow. Now, I may be sick in my body, but I'm going on anyhow. Body racking with pain, but I'm going on anyhow. Now, see, I don't have to deal with bills right now, but my parents do, and I know some of the older people do. But anytime you sit down looking at a $500 bill from Archibald, go on anyhow. Because he said he would be bread in a starving land. He told us that he'll be a bridge over troubled water. He said he is the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh to the Father but by me. All we got to do is put our hand in God's unchanging hand. Trust and depend on the Lord. Don't worry about what Billy and Bobby saying about you, because they don't have a heaven nor a hell to place you in. I'm going to press toward that mark, because I know that I have bigger and better things waiting on me. The Lord is waiting there telling me to come on. He's waiting to take me from here and take me higher and higher. Does anybody here have an anyhow attitude? Has anybody made up in their mind that if you don't go, I'm going to go on anyhow? No matter what the world may say, or no matter what the world may do, I've been picked out to be picked on. But in the end, by and by, it's all going to pay off after a while. I'm going to be able to see the man that died for me. I'm going to be able to walk streets that are paved with gold. I'm going to mount up wings as an angel. I'll be able to fly and not get tired. Every day is going to be like Sunday. But I've got to keep on keeping on. And I'm going to keep on with my anyhow attitude. The Bible tells us that we have to love our neighbors as ourselves. But any time they're stabbing us in our back, the human side of us wants to turn around and tell them a word or two. But the Christian side to us is telling us to turn around with a smile on your face and say, I love you anyhow. You're not big enough. You're not great enough. You're not holy. You're not my God, so I'm not going to lose my blessing over you. So I'm going to go on anyhow. I'm going to get the chance to see that man. So I'm going to go on anyhow. Great school. I've been in contact with the coaches recently, Coach McGriff's, Coach Gonella, and a number of others down there. I have a number of family down in Miami as well, which is on my dad's side. They've migrated south. So if I were to go there as well, I would be surrounded by family. It's a great school. It has rich history. And if history holds true, you can always expect something big out of Miami.
I said, come on out of your situation. I didn't put you here on earth to struggle and strain the entire time through. This is your life. I put you here to be great, and you're about to be great. Now, somebody is sitting in your jailhouse right now. But I encourage you, if you send up prayers to the Lord, if you pray steadfast, and be thrown not off course, the Lord will make a way in due time. He may not come when you want him to, but he's going to make a way. He's about to get ready to shake somebody's foundation. You've been sitting still for a while, but you're going to begin to feel a little bit in a little while. It may not be today, it might not be tomorrow, but somewhere down the road, the Lord is going to shake your foundation. And he's about to open up the doors that have been shut in your face. And the best part about it, when he opens up a door, no man can close it. Because what the Lord has for me, it is for me. And the Bible says, what God has put together, let no man separate. And see, the Lord has placed me here in his love, and he's put us together. So no man is going to tear me away from the love of God. But I got to keep on anyhow. I'm a high school student, and trials and tribulations come up around me all the time. I got my friends that come up, man, you don't never go out. Man, you don't never come to the parties, but I know that I have a higher goal in mind. Because I know when I get done down here, I have a mansion waiting on me. Now you can go on and you can look for self-fulfillment here.
But the Bible tells me that when I leave from down here, only my soul is going to cross over. I'm not worried about materialistic things. I'm setting my sights on things eternal. Now, working down here is like putting in on a timeshare. The more you put in determines how long you can stay in the timeshare. So the more work we put in down here determines what we're going to spend eternity.